Joshua chapter number 24. Oh, God help us this morning. Now, we're going to read. The Bible says, in verse 1, and Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem and called for the elders of Israel and for their head and for their judges and for their officers, and they presented themselves before God. It's not before Joshua, before God. So you are not here before me this morning, you are here before God. Praise God. The God, the maker of heaven and earth. God told us at the all night, he said, in Zion, I will bless you. Because I am the maker of heaven and earth. He said, men and women that forsook their sleep and come to Zion and lift up their hands all night and worship him and praise him and pray even for the nation. In their sinful act, you still pray for them. In their disobedient act, you still pray for them. In their wicked action, you still pray for them. He said, in Zion, I will bless you. And he confirmed that because he is the maker of heaven and earth. When God speaks, nobody can stand against you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
The Bible says they presented themselves before God. So we presented ourselves this morning before God. Not before men, not before women, not before me, apostle, but before God. He is our maker. He is whom we serve. And we serve the Lord. Come rain, come sun. Come whatever pitch that I fall into. My God, I will serve the Lord. Let it be dwelling in your spirit this morning. For one of these days you're going to fall into a pit. But I know in that pit there is always a way out for you. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, King of Glory.
Yes,
so that the devil would think that it's over concerning you. It's not just over, it's the beginning of the hands of God in your life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That will not permit me to narrate the story of Joseph. Hallelujah. They thought it was over. Yet the worst they could do was to sell him. They thought it was over. No. You see, sometimes the devil is helping you to arrange the fulfillment of the glory of God in your life. That time we have to be wise as a child of God, that the living God whom you put your hope and trust in will never fail you. Yes. I could try to move forward, but I'm taking some step backward. Trying to move forward, I'm taking some step backward because of just some challenges and the other. Man, I'm telling you, God said, all things work together
for good.
To you and I that love God, to you and I that are called according to his will and power. Man, I'm telling you, all things are working together for my good. Yes. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
The Bible says they presented themselves before God. It takes the spiritual mind to discern this. Yes, where is God? They presented themselves to. But they presented themselves before God. So as we gather here this morning, we gather ourselves before God.
Yes.
Not before anything, but before God. Now, the Bible says, and Joshua said unto all the people, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, your father dwelt on the other side of the flood in old time, even Terah, the fathers of Abraham, and the father of Nahor, and they served other gods. Verse 3, and I took your father Abraham from other side of the flood and led him throughout all the land of Canaan and multiplied his seed and gave him Isaac. God has multiplied my seed. He has multiplied your seed. He has given you your desire. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Father. He said, I gave him Isaac, and I gave unto Isaac Jacob and Esau. And I gave unto Esau Mount Seir, and to possess it. But to Jacob and his children, they went down. They went down to where? Egypt. No one went up. They went down. Remember how it started? It all started from oppression. Hallelujah.
Amen.
From oppression. They went down to Egypt. Does that stop the manifestation of the glory of God? No. You could be going down. Does that stop the manifestation of God's glory? No. It is you that will say to the devil, no and no. Because I know the Lord God whom I serve. I could be going down, he's lifting me higher. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Have you ever thought that whatever thing you could ask for big and God gave you little? Have you ever thought that that is the desire of God for your life? Just take it and appreciate God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, the Bible says in verse 5, I sent Moses, also and Aaron, and I plagued Egypt. That's my God. Somebody will say God cannot plague somebody else because of me. He will plague the nation for your sake. He will plague anything he wants to plague for your sake. That's our God. He has done it before. He's going to do it again. I look forward for God to do it. To plague men and women for my sake. All repentant men and women for your sake. I'm talking. Praise the Lord. He said he plagued Egypt, the whole nation. He plagued them. In other words, he suffered them. He afflicted them for the sake of his children. We ought to recount this. Do you know that God has plagued many for your sake since January to this very moment? Oh my God. I just want someone to shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said, do you know since January to this very moment, God has afflicted men and women for your sake that you may live? That's our God. He has dispossessed some. He has shifted some from their seat. He has blinded some. He has moved them. They only repented when he has led them. It's not me speaking. This is the word of God. He said that I plagued Egypt for your sake. Woo! Is our God trying to be biased? Is he trying to be wicked? No, he's God. He's God. He's God. My God, I'm talking. Any person that refuses to take hand off your destiny, God will plague him for your sake.
Amen.
Say a big amen to that somebody.
Amen.
Yes. Yes. That's our God. I believe this. I just believe this. This is my calling. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I look forward to see the devil trample under my foot all the time. I look forward to see the manifestation of the glory of God upon my life. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ said, the thief coming up but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. That is why God can never look back or front before he plagued the thief. He plagued them. Why? Because their heart is only for destruction. He plagued them. Now we move forward. We have seen the goodness of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That's why we declare this morning, we will serve the living God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you,
Lord. He said he plagued Egypt. According to that which I did among them. And afterward, I brought you out. See, that's how God worked. Woo! Verses. The Bible says, and I brought your father out of Egypt. And you came unto the sea. And the Egyptians pursued after your fathers with chariots and horsemen unto the Red Sea. And when they cry unto the Lord, how many of us offer petition before God since the beginning of this year? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes. How many of us pray to the Lord before from the beginning of this year? Since the beginning of this year, you have prayed to the Lord. This is exactly what the Israelites did. The Bible says the Egyptians pursued them even to the Red Sea. Listen, you may not have Egyptians in your life, but one way and the other, you must have been pursued to the point that you have to cry to the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We have seen the goodness of God. We look at our left, our right, our front, our back. We have seen the goodness of God. For the devil, he wants to kill you with ordinary cough. I'm talking. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because why is the devil? Because why? The Bible told me that their only work is to destroy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But God has laid them for your sake. That is why we gathered this morning and said, we will serve the Lord. Because we have seen his goodness. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. This is not a time to pet the devil. It's a time to say to the devil, I have seen the goodness of God. Why? Because God has plagued you for my sake. Oh, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, King of Glory.
Amen.
And the Bible says, in verse 7, the Bible says, and they cried unto the Lord, he put darkness between you and the Egyptian. The Bible says, as they cried unto the Lord God himself, he put a demarcation, he put darkness, he blinded the eyes of your pursuer. What a mighty God we serve. If you don't know, that is why you are being told right now that since the beginning of this year, 2014, God has blinded the eyes of your pursuer. The unrepented one, God plagued them. God afflicted them. Hallelujah. The Bible says God put darkness between the Israelite and the Egyptian. In other words, he confuses the Egyptian for my sake. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes we need to be told the doings of the Lord. So that we cannot be carried away. So that we cannot look at our palm and say, hey, my hand has got me this. Ha. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that we cannot just palm our chest and say, hey, come on, I'm the strongest man. Listen to me. It's the doings of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Should I tell you the day you choose to be a strong man? The very moment you gave your life to Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, that is the moment you choose to be a strong man, stronger than any other man that ever lived on the face of the earth. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Paul told us that we must be boast in the Lord. Boast in the Lord. Let your boast be in the Lord. Praise the Lord. The word of God declares. The Bible says, and he brought the sea upon the Egyptian and covered them. And your eyes have seen what I have done in Egypt. And ye dwell in the wilderness long season. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is remembering the Israelite. What he has done. Hallelujah. The Bible says, remember where we started from. Joshua called them and they gathered themselves together before God. And Joshua started telling them all that the Lord God has done for them. When Joshua knew, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You yourself are under the sound of my voice. You knew one thing and the other the Lord God has done for you. Praise the Lord. You knew some challenges that you found yourself. You thought that you were not going out. You thought that here the devil has got you. But God put darkness between you and them. Praise the Lord. That they could not see you any longer. He blessed them for your sake. My God. Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
He just blessed them for your sake. That's God whom we serve. I just want us to sincerely take this home. That God has blessed my enemy for my sake. Praise the Lord. That is where we must be very careful in serving the Lord. That is why we must be ready to offer everything unto the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because it costs God. It costs God. His own dear son to purchase us unto himself.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, for we are born with a price. He will do everything possible to save us, to protect us, so that the devil cannot mock our God. I'm speaking this morning. Praise the Lord. You see, this message is preparing you for on the 29th of this month. We have it on our annual anniversary, annual general thanksgiving. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So that when you are coming here that very day, all this world, you have eaten, you know where you are coming, and you know the reason you are here, you know what you are going to do. You know why it is necessary for you to bless the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Look at what the Bible says in verse 8. Mm-hmm. And I brought you unto the land of the Amorite, which dwell in the other side. Jordan, and they fought with you, and I gave them unto your hand, that you might possess their land, and I destroyed them from before you. Is it your power? No. That's why God is often saying, praise thy Lord. Listen, these are nations. And who make a nation? It's the people that make a nation. God said he destroyed nation. When God said he destroyed nation, he's not talking about the land. He destroyed kings and nobles for the sake of his children. I just too much love God. That is why I must be very careful of my salvation. Hallelujah. That is why I must handle my salvation very, 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 very important. I must handle my God as a vital necessity in my life. God said, he suffered all the nation for our sake. He destroyed all the nation that we might possess the land. So he does not destroy all the good things so that we can possess all the good things. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, King of Glory.
Thank you, Lord.
Look what the Bible says. In verse 9. Then Balak, the son of Zippor, king of Moab, arose and warred against Israel and sent to call Balaam, the son of Beor, to curse you. Ha. Am I speaking this morning? The Bible says, Balak, the king of Moab, arose and called for a prophet to curse Israel. To curse them. Why? Because they tried to persecute them, but they could not. They tried to kill them, but they could not. They tried to destroy them, to confuse them, but they could not. Oh yeah, they say, hey, whoever that is cursed, let anything happen, that curse will be working. Now let them be cursed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To curse Israel. But God could not let it happen. Hallelujah. Did you know many have gathered together in the evil world to curse you, but it did not happen? I'm talking. Men and women have brought your matter to witchcraft doctor and make sure your name, the man slept off, because they will not tell you what happened the time they died. I'm talking. Men and women have brought your matter to witchcraft doctor and fire kingdom. It has happened. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody rose up in the morning and deleted your number out of his or her phone. It has happened. Why? Because the Lord God plagued them and warned them. I'm talking. Somebody just suddenly packed his or her house, packed, and moved away from the apartment you are, moved away from your street. Why? Because when he sees you, the dread of you God has put on your head that begin to dread men and women, he sees you. He cannot take it. I have seen that. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I believe I'm communicating this morning, because this is not my original word this morning. When I go to the church, God said, say to my people, serve me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Now look at what the word of God says. He said to curse Israel. But I would not hearken unto Balaam. Therefore, he blesses you still. So I deliver you out of his hand. Woo! Praise the Lord. God said he wouldn't listen to the voice of Balaam. He wouldn't listen to the voice of your adversary. He wouldn't listen to the voice of those men and women that knew you right from the womb, that knew you where you were born, that knew that nurtured you. He wouldn't listen to their voice. Are you too awesome? Are you too beautiful? Just why? Because you are of God. The Bible says he wouldn't listen to him to curse you, but rather he blesses you. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes, that's why God hates complaining. God hates complaining. He wants his children to always see victory all the time. You could be disappointed. Do you know that it's for your good? Praise the Lord. Yeah, men and women could disappoint you. It is for your good. I'm speaking. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says Balaam could not curse them. Why? Because God did not allow him. And he only allowed Balaam to bless Israel. To bless Israel. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
He only allowed Balaam. You see, the grace of God in this household, even men and women that are not here that have already been blessed in this household, God told me some time ago that the same power is still blessing them. The same grace is still covering them. Hallelujah. The same blessing is still upon them. Praise the Lord. Why? Because you have called them brethren. I'm speaking this morning. Why? Because one way or the other, they have contributed financially to the building of this household. I'm speaking this morning. Praise the Lord. Not to talk about you that is in the house. My God. Thank you, Father. He said he wouldn't allow Balaam to curse you. He wouldn't allow men and women to walk against you. Rather, they bless you. Yes. Yes. Joshua speaking to the children of Israel. Yeah, this is the right time to speak this word. My God can never lie. I am putting it back to your mind what God has done for you. Hallelujah. What the enemy meant for evil, God turning around for your good. He blesses you, the Bible says. Thank you, Father. The Bible declares. In verse 10. But I will not hearken unto Balaam, therefore he blesses you still. So I delivered you out of his hand. Verse 11. And you went over Jordan and came unto Jericho. And the men of Jericho fought against you. The Amorite, the Perizzite, the Canaanite, the Hittite, the Girgashite, the Hivite, and the Jebusite. And I delivered them unto your hands. Did you want to fight with all these names that I just mentioned before you believe what I'm saying? But I want to say to you one way and the other, you have fought with the Jebusite. You have fought with the Amorite. You have entangled yourself with the Canaanite. But God delivered you. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Father. The Canaanite will be your neighbor. The Jebusite could be somebody back home in Africa. The Canaanite could be somebody right beside where you work, your co-worker. The Canaanite could be somebody who want to terminate you on time, who want to destroy your salvation. The Canaanite could be your mind. The Bible says God did not allow it to happen. Praise the Lord. The Bible says God delivered you out of their hand. Now look at what the Bible says. And I sent the hermit before you. Verse 12. He said, I fear the hermit before you. You know when the Bible says hermit? In other words, he stamped on you, on your forehead, great dread. That when your adversary will see your forehead, they will be dreadful. That is what the Bible calls hermit. So before I enter somebody's house, they already tremble. He's coming again. My God. Before you step into that office, the manager already trembled and fell. He or she got a job. I'm speaking. Before you even come to that light, before you go and step anywhere, before God has already sent a hermit before you, he's going before you. That when they see your forehead, touch no my anointing and do my prophet no harm. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm speaking good this morning. Thank you, King of Glory. Amen. We need to be told all these things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, King of Glory.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Yes. He said, I sent my hermit before you, which drove them out from before you. The fear of you drives away your adversary before you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Even the two kings of Amora, but not with a sword, not with a bow. And I have given you a land for which you did not labor, my God, and city which you did not build, and ye dwell in them of, and ye dwell in them of their vineyard and olive yard, which ye planted not, do ye eat? Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, sometimes when they are talking about discrimination and racism and all those things, it happened to the children of Israel. I just want to advise somebody this morning that you shouldn't be moved by that. The Lord God allowed it. Praise the Lord. Now I'm speaking to somebody. All you need to do is just lift up your hands in the morning and stretch forth your hands to the nation. He said, I command every evil to stop. Praise the Lord. Don't you know you are responsible to do that? You just said, I command every evil to stop. I was reading an article yesterday. They said racism in this nation has risen since 2010. Very high. It has risen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
They said something has triggered it. Yes. We are not moved by that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are not touched by that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Do you know why? Why? Because the house you did not build, God gave it to you. The land you did not build, somebody said to me, he said, the land you guys came over, now you are acting as if you are the lord of the land. Do you know that our first father fought for this land, fought the British? I just look at him and laugh. And I thank God that you saw me walking as a king in this land. It is the Lord doing, and it is marvelous in our life. It is marvelous in our sight. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I just look at him and laugh. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
So it's your responsibility to stretch forth your hand toward the nation. And then, Father, you have blessed me. You have brought me to this nation that I might be blessed. You declare that wheresoever the soles of my feet shall tread upon, you have given unto me for my possession. Thank you for possessing it. May this blessing rest upon this nation. He told Abraham, I will bless them that bless you. And I will curse you that curse you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Let it hide. Don't concern me. I'm not leaving. This is my nation. I'm not going to Africa. This is my nation. Hallelujah. I can only pay a visit to Africa. I'm talking. I cannot be in two places. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm talking. This is my nation. God brought me here. God brought me here. I am actually choose me, not me that choose this country. They choose me. I was very young when I see this nation in my revelation those days. Greenland, 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 Greenland. Oh, sometimes when I'm walking, I go, oh, yeah. When I was 5, I saw this land. So something wanted to tell me because of racism, I should go. I'm not going. I'm not going anywhere. Praise the Lord. So some of us have not made up our mind. That's why we are still, you know, Somebody once told me, he said, I've been in this nation now, I haven't achieved anything. In London, I have my council flag. I said, why did you leave your council flag? Praise the Lord. You should have stayed in London. Council flag taken back away from him. This and that. And I said, you should have stayed in London. Praise the Lord. Open eyes. Can't be in two places. You can't sleep too bad and wake up at the same time. Praise the Lord. You see, sometimes we need to be satisfied. We need to see what God has done for us. Praise the Lord. God said he brought us to the nation we did not build. Praise the Lord. He gave us money we did not work. Money. Thank you, Jesus. Which nation would you don't work and you earn? Which nation? In your nation, do they do that to you? Where you come from, your country. They will beat you and they will kill you and nobody will ask. What you did not do, they will put it upon your head. Nobody will defend you. Don't you know where we came from? So because when the winter comes, we begin to challenge and say, oh, this country, go to your nation. I know many of them that back in Nigeria now, when little fever hold them, they run back here for medical care.
Yes.
They can't treat themselves.
Yeah.
When malaria attack them, they run back here. Those ungrateful men and women, immigration begin to catch them.
Yeah.
Begin to catch them. Ungrateful men and women unto God. That are destroying the image of Nigerians, the image of Africans in this nation. The hands that go into the hole, the snake will bite.
Yes,
enough is enough. We all came to this country one way or the other, legally or illegally. Enough is enough. We have gotten what we want. We should appreciate God. Praise the Lord. He brought us here. Forget about the races. Forget about the comment. Bless them, God said. Bless them. Bless them. Hallelujah. Would you not be jealous if somebody comes to your land and raping all that your grandfather or your first father have sold? But then you will carry a gun and shoot them. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, King of Glory. To advise anyone this morning, all we need to do for them is to pray for them. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Don't be rash. Don't retaliate. Just look at them and bless them. This is the best country God has brought us to. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Where are we? Praise the Lord. Verse 14. And the Bible says, now therefore, Joshua speaking to the children of Israel, he said, now therefore fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in truth, and put away the gods which your father served on the other side of the flood and in Egypt, and serve ye the living God. And if you see it evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose ye these days whom you will serve, whether the gods which your father said that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of Amorah in those lands ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's personal. Praise the Lord. He has commanded them, but he ended up his speech by saying, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. It's personal. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. For our first father served those gods of the other side, the God of the other flood, they all died. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And look what the Bible says. And the people answered and said unto God, unto Joshua, God forbid that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For the Lord our God, he is he that has brought us all out and our father out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage, which did those great signs in our sight, and preserve us in all the way wherein we went, and among all the people through whom we passed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 18, the last verse. And the Lord drove out from before you and I all the people, even the Amorites, we dwell in the land. Wherefore, we also serve the Lord, for he is our God. When I remember his promises, I shall